Okay, so today I'm here with John from the bada team of Samsung Mobile Innovator. Hi, John. I think you're going to be talking to us about security today.
Yeah, I'm going to introduce bada security classes and show you how to make use of three main security features. We'll look at encryption and decryption, which prevents your information from being compromised. Then we'll introduce digital signatures, which are used to ensure that you know who sent you a message. And then finally, we'll explain hashes. And you can think of these like fingerprints, which can be used to see if a message has been altered.
But John, I'm just starting out with bada. Isn't this subject a little bit complicated?
Well, it is a complicated subject, but we're going to take a practical approach. We're going to introduce the namespaces and classes and walk you through code examples that you can make use of in your own applications.
But John, why is security important?
Well, it's a serious topic. In 2008, victims lost $265 million through internet fraud in the US alone. We're keeping more and more confidential and private information on mobile devices and using applications running on these devices to distribute it. So dealing with security properly is critical. Bada provides developers with a full range of security features. That's what makes it a great choice for secure communication. Let's start with the first security feature in Bada, encrypting and decrypting information for exchange.
So John, can you tell me more about the example we'll be using today?
Well, we'll be using the classic example, Alice and Bob. Now, Alice and Bob are working together on a top secret project in different countries. They need to exchange messages, but have to be sure that the confidential information does not fall into the hands of their deadly competitor, Eve. But they only have access to non-secure means of communication, so they have to encrypt their messages. Encrypting each message with a password isn't enough, since they don't have a secure way of exchanging that password. And even the best passwords can be cracked by an eavesdropper, like Eve. So, Alice and Bob decide to use public-private key encryption to protect their messages.
Now, this is the complicated part. Can you tell me some more about this?
Yeah, let's see that in action. We generate a mathematically related pair of keys. A public key, which we make available for others to encrypt messages to send to us, and a private key, which we keep secret and use to decrypt messages encrypted with our public key. Messages encrypted with our public key can only be decrypted with our private key.
Okay, John, how secure is this?
Well, it's very secure. In practice, it's too complex to derive the private key from the public key. For strong algorithms, it's impossible. To send a message to Bob, Alice will encrypt the message with Bob's public key, which is published. Bob will decrypt it with his private key. Now, even if Eve, who's their deadly competitor, remember, has intercepted the message, she can't decrypt its contents. To send the message back to Alice, Bob will encrypt the message with Alice's public key, and Alice will decrypt the message with her private key. This is how they can exchange secure messages over an insecure connection. Let's see some real code. To simulate sending a message between Alice and Bob, we created a simple bada project with two forms, Alice form and Bob form. Here's our Alice form, used to send and encrypt the message to send to Bob. And here's our Bob form, which receives and decrypts the messages from Alice.
Okay, John, what classes do I need to use to implement encryption for my messages?
The classes which implement public-private key encryption are part of the security namespace. Now, as we can see, the key pair generator class generates a key pair which contains the objects represented by the public key and private key classes. You'll notice that the UML diagram also shows a secret key generator and secret key classes. These are used for symmetric encryption, where the same key is used to both encrypt and decrypt a message.
What could that be used for?
It could be used for password protecting a file, for example.
So, John, what class implements the encryption?
Well, the encryption is done by the RsaCipher class, which is part of the security crypto sub-namespace. RsaCipher is related to iKey, the implementation of which is the public or private key used to encrypt the message.
So John, how do we generate the keys?
Well, Bob's public and private keys are generated in the BobForm method generateKeys. Now let's have a look at that. We construct an object of key pair generator, which is the bada class used to generate public-private key pairs. The key pair generator's constructor takes an integer as a parameter.
What's the significance of the integer?
Well, that's the size of the key to be generated, and it can be either 1024 or 2048 bytes. And the larger the key, the more difficult it is to crack. We then call the method generateKeyPairN to generate the key pairs which are stored in pbob private key and pbob public key. We'll send Bob's public key to Alice to encrypt messages, and Bob's private key will be kept secret. For demonstration in our example, we simply set a member of Alice form to pbob public key.
So now that Alice has Bob's public key,
she'll use that public key to send him a message. So let's have a look at how that's implemented in code. We enter a message in the text area of the Alice form, and we store it in the string pmessage. We then call the method encryptMessage to encrypt the message to send to Bob. Now the first thing we do is we create an RsaCipher, and that's the class that provides methods for encryption and decryption. The setPublicKey method is then called to set up the cipher with Bob's public key as a parameter, and we'll use that to encrypt the message. Next, we convert our message string into a byte buffer. You'll notice that all of our encryption and decryption functions take byte buffers as parameters and return them as function results. Flip is just a utility method used to reset our buffer. To actually do the encryption, we call encryptN, which takes the message buffer as a parameter and returns the encrypted version.
So who can actually decrypt this message?
Well, the message can only be decrypted with Bob's private key, and if he's kept it a secret, only Bob can read the message.
So John, how does Bob decrypt the message?
Bob decrypts the message in the Bob form method decrypt with private key. All we need to do is create an RsaCipher object and set it up to use Bob's private key. We then call decryptN, and this will return the decrypted version of our message.
In what circumstances can decryption fail?
What if we supplied the wrong private key, for example? In that case, decryptN would return null. Let's launch our project and see how Alice sends a secure message to Bob. In the Alice form, we type in the message that Alice will send to Bob. We click the encrypt button, and that will encrypt it with Bob's public key. The encrypted message is then shown in the window.
And this can only be decrypted using Bob's private key.
That's correct. We then click send, and the action shifts to Bob form, where the encrypted message has been received.
Bob can decrypt the message using his private key, and the message can be read.
In part one, we introduced bada security classes and showed you how to use public-private key encryption.
So John, can you tell me what's going to be happening in part two?
Well, in part two, we're going to be looking at digital signatures and hashes.